Hello everyone. In this video session, we will be discussing orthogonal components or pencils of three-level factorial design. We will be illustrating the concept using 3:2 factorial design or 3-square factorial design. So we assume let x1 and x2 denote the levels of the factors a and b respectively. That is, x1, x2 both can assume value 0, 1 and 2. The 9 treatment combinations expressed digitally using the digits 0, 1, 2 can always be categorized into 3 groups of equal size, such that in a particular group the factor's level is constant. Then these group totals can be compared to find the main effect of a factor. For example, the following 3 groups are categorized for the 3 levels of factor A. We can observe for x1 equal to 0, the 3 treatment combinations are 00, 01 and 02. If you notice, the first digit of all the 3 treatment combinations are 0, and this satisfies the equation x1 equal to 0. The next group is of 10, 11 and 12, and the first digit of all these 3 treatment combination is 1, and this satisfy the equation x1 equal to 1. Similarly, the last group is 20, 21 and 22, and this satisfy the equation x1 equal to 2. The function modulus 3 mentioned in the bracket against all the 3 equations is not of much use here, but it will be utilized when we will be forming the groups for the interactions. Similarly, the main effect of B is comparison of groups of points for which x2 equal to 0, 1, 2. That is, the 3 equations are x2 equal to 0, x2 equal to 1 and x2 equal to 2. And corresponding to these 3 equations, the treatment combinations are written against them. So if we see, for x2 equal to 0, the 3 treatment combinations put in one group each have the second digit as 0. In the second group, each treatment combination has second digit as 1, satisfying x2 equal to 1. And in the last group, each treatment combination has second digit equal to 2, satisfying x2 equal to 2. The set of equations that produce the 3 groups for interaction component AB square with corresponding groups are x1 plus 2x2 equal to 0 modulus 3, x1 plus 2x2 equal to 1 modulus 3, and x1 plus 2x2 equal to 2 modulus 3. And the corresponding group of treatment combinations are written against these equations. To understand how these treatment combinations are produced by these equations, let us take the first equation x1 plus 2x2 equal to 0 modulus 3 and see how the 3 treatment combinations 00, 11 and 22 are generated using this equation. The treatment combination that correspond to equation x1 plus 2x2 equal to 0 modulus 3 are 00, 11 and 22. Now let us see if these treatment combinations satisfy this equation. So we will choose 00 and put in place of x1 and x2, and obviously 0 plus 2 times 0 is going to be 0. Now let us take the next treatment combination, which is 11. So in place of x1 we put 1, and in place of x2 we put 1. This produces 1 plus 2 times 1, which is equal to 3, and modulus of 3 is equal to 0. Now we verify the treatment combination 22. So we see that 2 plus 2 times 2 is equal to 6. And 6 modulus 3 is equal to 0 again. So we see that all these 3 treatment combination satisfy the equation x1 plus 2x2 is equal to 0 modulus 3. The treatment combination that correspond to the equation x1 plus 2x2 is equal to 1 modulus 3 are 10, 21 and 02. Now let us see if these treatment combinations satisfy this equation. Let us start with 1. So in place of x1 we put 1 and in place of x2 we put 0. So 1 plus 2 times 0 is equal to 1. Evaluating using modulus 3, we see that 1 modulus 3 is equal to 1. Now we evaluate the treatment combination 2, 1. So in place of x1 we put 2 and in place of x2 we put 1, which is equal to 4, and modulus 3 of 4 is again 1. The last treatment combination 0, 2, we get 0 plus 2 times 2, which is again equal to 4. Modulus 3 is equal to 1. Hence we see that all these treatment combinations satisfy this equation, or one can say how these treatment combinations are categorized in one group using the equation x1 plus 2x2 equal to 1 modulus 3. Now let us see if the treatment combination that satisfy the equation x1 plus 2x2 equal to 2 modulus 3, and the treatment combinations are 0, 1, 2, 0 and 1, 2. So let us see if treatment combination 0, 1 satisfies the equation x1 plus 2x2 equal to 2 modulus 3. So in place of x1 we put 0, in place of x2 we put 1, which is equal to 2, and 2 modulus 3 is equal to 2. In place of x1 now we put 2 and in place of x2 we put 0 for the treatment combination 2, 0, and we get 2 modulus 3, which is again equal to 2. And we evaluate now treatment combination 1, and we see that 1 plus 2 times 2 is equal to 5, and 5 modulus 3 is equal to 2. Hence we see that all these three treatment combination also satisfy the equation to which they correspond. Similarly, 2x1 plus x2 equal to 0, 1, 2 produce the set of groups for a square b. The three equations are 2x1 plus x2 equal to 0, 2x1 plus x2 equal to 1, and 2x1 plus x2 equal to 2. And the corresponding group of treatment combinations are written against the equation. We see that treatment combination 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2 correspond to the equation 2x1 plus x2 equal to 0 modulus 3. Now let us see if these treatment combinations satisfy this equation. So in place of x1 and x2 we put 0, 0. So 2 times 0 plus 0 equal to, of course, 0, and modulus of 3 of 0 is equal to 0. And now we evaluate 1, 1. 2 times 1 plus 1 is equal to 3. Modulus 3 is equal to 0. And 2 times 2 plus 2 is equal to 6. Modulus 3 is equal to 0. Similarly, the treatment combinations 0, 1, 2, 0 and 1, 2 will satisfy the equation 2x1 plus x2 equal to 1 modulus 3. And 1, 0, 2, 1 and 0, 2 will satisfy the equation 2x1 plus x2 equal to 2 modulus 3. The readers can verify this. If you notice, the set of groups produced for AB square and A square B are same. The group of treatment combinations 0, 0, 1, 1 and 2, 2 are produced by x1 plus 2x2 equal to 0 modulus 3, and also by 2x1 plus x2 equal to 0 modulus 3. Similarly, x1 plus 2x2 equal to 1 and 2x1 plus x2 equal to 2 produce 1, 0, 2, 1 and 0, 2. And finally, x1 plus 2x2 equal to 2 and 2x1 plus x2 equal to 1 produce 0, 1, 2, 0 and 1, 2. In fact, from the set of equations for AB square, one can find the set of equations for A square B also. For example, the first equation for the component AB square is x1 plus 2x2 is equal to 0 modulus 3. If I multiply this equation by 2 throughout, I will find that 2x1 plus 4x2 is equal to 0 modulus 3. Now this coefficient of x2 is 4. This coefficient, since it exceeds 3, it must be evaluated using modulus 3 function, and this becomes 2x1 plus x2 is equal to 0 modulus 3. Now the next equation is x1 plus 2x2 is equal to 1 modulus 3. Again we multiply by 2 throughout and we find 2x1 plus 4x2 is equal to 2 modulus 3. Now again this coefficient of x2, which is 4, must be evaluated using modulus 3, and we find 2x1 plus x2 is equal to 2 modulus 3. Similarly, the last equation for ab square, x1 plus 2x2 is equal to 2 modulus 3. We multiply by 2 throughout. We get 2x1 plus 4x2 is equal to 4 modulus 3. All the coefficients or numbers that exceed 3 must be evaluated using modulus 3 function, and we find 2x1 plus x2 is equal to 1 modulus 3. And this is how we find the three set of equations for the component a square b. Similarly, x1 plus x2 equal to 0, 1, 2 produce the three groups for interaction component AB. The groups produced for A square B square using 2x1 plus 2x2 equal to 0, 1, 2 are same as those produced for AB. This can be verified in the following table. The treatment combination 0, 0, 1, 2 and 2, 1 can be produced using the equations x1 plus x2 equal to 0 and also 2x1 plus 2x2 equal to 0 modulus 3. Similarly, 1, 0, 0, 1 and 2, 2 can be produced using the equations x1 plus x2 equal to 1 modulus 3 and 2x1 plus 2x2 equal to 2 modulus 3. And finally, the last group of treatment combinations 1, 1, 2, 0 and 0, 2 can be produced using the equations x1 plus x2 equal to 2 modulus 3 and 2x1 plus 2x2 equal to 1 modulus 3. Again, if you notice, the set of equations for a square b square can be found from that of AB by simply multiplying the constant 2 throughout the equations. For example, if I multiply 2 in the first equation, I will get 2x1 plus 2x2 equal to 0 modulus 3, which is same as this equation. Similarly, if I multiply 2 in the next equation, I will see that 2x1 plus 2x2 equal to 2 modulus 3, which is same as the equation for a square b square. And finally, 2x1 plus 2x2 equal to 4 modulus 3. 4 must be evaluated using modulus 3 function and we will get 1. So it reduces to 1 modulus 3 and we get 2x1 plus 2x2 is equal to 1 modulus 3. Therefore, the components ALBQ and AQBL or AB square and A square B are called I component of interaction AB. That is, I of AB equal to AB square, because the three groups of treatment combinations produced for AB square and A square B are same. Components AB and A square B are called J component of interaction AB. That is, J of AB is equal to AB, because the group of treatment combinations found for AB and A square B square are same. These I and J components of the interaction AB are also denoted by P12 and P11 respectively, called as pencils. That is, I of AB is equal to AB square is equal to P of 12. J of AB is equal to AB and denoted by P11. Thus, main effect of A and B are denoted by P10 and P01 respectively. Notice that in the parenthesis after P, the numbers are the powers of the letters A and B. These components or pencils are mutually orthogonal. So the component AB represents both AB and A square B square. Component AB square represents both AB square and A square B. Note that in both I and J components denoted by AB square and AB, the exponent of the first letter is 1. Actually, when considering expression of the form A raised to P, B raised to Q, we establish a convention that only exponent allowed on the first letter is 1. If the first letter's exponent is not 1, then entire expression is squared and the exponents are reduced modulus 3. For example, A square B is same as AB square because A square B equal to square of A square B, which is equal to A raised to 4 B square. Evaluate the exponents using modulus 3 and we see that 4 modulus 3 is equal to 1. So A raised to 4 becomes A and 2 modulus 3 is still 2, so B square remains as it is. Similarly, AB is equal to A square B square upon squaring. These components do not have any physical meaning, but play an important role in construction of the more complicated designs. For instance, in confounded design and fractional factorial design, if A square B is confounded, then AB square also gets confounded automatically. If AB is confounded, then A square B square also get confounded automatically. Therefore, we need representative of these interactions. Therefore, AB is chosen as the representative of AB and A square B square together. AB square is chosen as representative of AB square and A square B together. The significance of these pencils or components P10, P01, P11 and P12 can be tested through ANOVA. We denote T010 and T110 and T210 as the sum of the elements in the groups for X1 equal to 0, X1 equal to 1 and X1 equal to 2 respectively constructed for A, that is P10. This we can understand from this table. For example, T010 is sum of the yields on the treatment combination 00, 01 and 02. T110 is sum of the yields on the treatment combinations 10, 11 and 12. And T2 of 10 is sum of the yields 20, 21 and 22. Similarly, TK01, K equal to 012 denote the sum of the elements in the groups for X2 equal to 012 respectively constructed for B, that is P01. So we see that the sum of the elements in the three groups constructed using X2 equal to 0, X2 equal to 1 and X2 equal to 2 for the pencil P01 or the component B. The total of these treatment combinations are T0-01, T1-01 and T2-01. That is, T0-01 is sum of the yields 00, 10 and 20, similarly others. TK of 11, K equal to 012 denote the sum of the elements in the groups constructed for AB, that is P11. This we can see from this table. T0-11 is sum of the yields in the group found using the equation x1 plus x2 equal to 0. T111 is sum of the yields 100122 found using the equation x1 plus x2 equal to 1. And T211 is sum of the yields found using the equation x1 plus x2 equal to 2 modulus 3. TK12, K equal to 012 denote the sum of the elements in the group constructed for AB square, that is P of 12. And this we can see from this table. T012 is sum of the yields on the treatment combination grouped using the equation X1 plus 2X2 equal to 0. Similarly, T1 of 12 is sum of the yields on the treatment combinations grouped using the equation x1 plus 2x2 equal to 1. And similarly, the other total T2 of 1,2 is sum of the yields on the treatment combinations 0, 1, 2, 2, 0 and 1, 2 grouped using the equation x1 plus 2x2 equal to 2 modulus 3. Now we find sum of squares for these pencils. Sum of squares corresponding to P10 is sum of square of TK10 divided by 3N minus the correction factor, which is G square by 9N, that is square of sum of all the observation divided by total number of observations, which are 9N. Sum of square corresponding to pencil P01 is sum of square of TK01 dividing by 3N minus the correction factor. Sum of square corresponding to P11 is similarly sum of square of TK11 divided by 3N minus the correction factor. And finally, sum of square for P12 is sum of square of TK12 divided by 3N minus the correction factor. In general, sum of square corresponding to P alpha 1 alpha 2 is equal to sum of square of TK of alpha 1 alpha 2 divided by 3N minus the correction factor, where alpha 1 and alpha 2 can assume value 0, 1, 2. Where TK alpha 1 alpha 2 denote the sum of the yields in the kth group, where K runs from 0, 1, 2, corresponding to alpha 1 x1 plus alpha 2 x2 equal to K modulus 3 for the pencil P alpha 1 P alpha 2. That is, if we want to find the group totals for P12, then the equation that will be used is x1 plus 2x2 equal to k modulus 3, where k can assume value 0, 1, 2. And the corresponding group totals will be denoted by tk 1, 2, and k can assume values 0, 1, 2. Let us see ANOVA for the pencils. The source of variation are P10, P01, P11 and P12, each with 2 degrees of freedom. We can also write A in place of P10, B in place of P01, AB in place of P11 and AB square in place of P12. If the design is replicated n times, then the total degrees of freedom is 9n-1, because in each replication there will be 9 observations. The remaining degrees of freedom is assigned to the error. We discussed the computation of sum of square for the pencils. The mean square for the pencils is simply the sum of square for the pencils divided by the corresponding degrees of freedom. And then in the last column we have the F statistic, which is mean sum of square for the pencils divided by the mean sum of square due to error. Now let us discuss the components for 3:3 factorial design. Suppose there are 3 factors A, B and C, each at 3 levels. Each main effect has 2 degrees of freedom, and each 2 factor interaction has 4 degrees of freedom, and 3 factor interaction has 8 degrees of freedom. If there are n replicates, then there are 3:3 into n minus 1 total degrees of freedom, and 3:3 times n minus 1 degrees of freedom associated with error. If the factors are quantitative, then main effects can be partitioned into linear and quadratic components, each with 1 degree of freedom. A 2-factor interaction can be decomposed into LL, LQ, QL and QQ components, each with 1 degree of freedom. For example, if it is interaction AB, then LL represents AL, BL, LQ represents AL, BQ, QL represents AQBL and QQ represents AQBQ. 3-factor interaction ABC can be divided into 8 components, each with single degree of freedom. We can partition the 2-factor interactions into their I and J components, each with 2 degrees of freedom, as I of AB is equal to AB square and J of AB is equal to AB. I of AC is equal to AC square and J of AC is equal to AC. I of BC is equal to BC square and J of BC is equal to BC. Similarly, ABC can be partitioned into four orthogonal components W, X, Y and Z, each with 2 degrees of freedom. W of ABC is equal to AB square C square, which is also denoted by P122. See, the digits in the parenthesis are the exponents of the letters A, B and C. X of ABC is equal to AB square C, which is denoted by P121. Y of ABC is equal to AB square, which is denoted by P112. And Z of ABC is equal to ABC, which is denoted by P11. Note that the W component of ABC can be found by finding the I component of AB and then finding the I component of I of AB into C. Similarly, X component of ABC can be found by first finding the I component of AB and then J component of I of AB into C. Y component of ABC is found by finding the J component of AB first and then I component of J of AB into C. Z of ABC is J component of J of AB into C. Let us understand this, how this happens. W of ABC is I of AB into C. Now, I of AB is actually equal to AB square into C, and I of AB square into C we can write as AB square into C square. X of ABC is equal to J of I of AB into C, which is equal to J of I of AB is AB square into C, and J of AB square into C will be AB square C. Note that in order to find the J of AB square into C, we treat AB square as one letter and C as the another. Similarly, Y of ABC is I of J of AB into C. Now, J of AB is equal to AB into C. To evaluate I of AB into C, we treat AB as one letter. So, I of AB into C will become AB C square, and Z of ABC is equal to J of AB into C. We know J of AB is equal to AB into C as it is. To evaluate J of AB into C, we treat AB as one letter and we get AB into C. The following table gives us the set of equations that can be used to partition the treatment combinations into three groups for comparison and estimating main effects and components of interaction effects for three level factorial design with three factors. The three equations for effect or component A is x1 equal to I modulus 3, where I can assume value 0, 1, 2. That is, we have three equations for the three groups for effect A. That is x1 equal to 0 modulus 3, x1 equal to 1 modulus 3, and x1 equal to 2 modulus 3. Similarly, the three equations for B are x2 equal to I modulus 3, where I can assume the three values 0, 1, 2. For C, it is x3 equal to I modulus 3, I equal to 0, 1, 2. For AB, the set of equations are x1 plus x2 equal to I modulus 3. For AB square, it is x1 plus 2x2 equal to I modulus 3. For AC, it is x1 plus x3 equal to I modulus 3. For AC, it is x1 plus 2x3 equal to I modulus 3. For BC, it is x2 plus x3 equal to I modulus 3. For BC square, x2 plus 2, x3 equal to I modulus 3. For AB, C, it is x1 plus x2 plus x3 equal to I modulus 3. For AB square, C, it is x1 plus 2, x2 plus x3 equal to I modulus 3. And ABC square, it is x1 plus x2 plus 2, x3 equal to I modulus 3. And AB square, C square, it is x1 plus 2, x2 plus 2, x3 equal to I modulus 3. The pencils for these effects or component can be denoted by P of the exponents of the letters in the parenthesis. In general, the set of equations are alpha 1 x1 plus alpha 2 x2 plus alpha 3 x3 is equal to I mod of 3, where I can assume value 0, 1, 2. And alpha 1, alpha 2, and alpha 3 can also assume value 0, 1, 2 according as the exponent of the letter present in the interaction. And x1, x2, and x3 are the levels of the factors in the treatment combinations. For example, if we want to find the equation that finds the three groups for the component A, B square C, then alpha is equal to 1 as the exponent of A is 1, alpha 2 is equal to 2 because the exponent of B is 2, and alpha 3 is equal to 1 because the exponent of C is equal to 1. And the equation we get is x1 plus 2x2 plus x3 is equal to I modulus 3. So now we know the set of equations for each component to produce the groups, and hence we can find the group totals, and those group totals can be used to find the sum of squares. So if I denote TK alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3 as the group total for K equal to 0, 1, 2 corresponding to equation alpha 1 x1 plus alpha 2 x2 plus alpha 3 x3 equal to K modulus 3 for the pencil P alpha 1 alpha 2 alpha 3, then the sum of square for P alpha 1 alpha 2 alpha 3 is sum of square of T K of alpha 1 alpha 2 alpha 3 divided by 9n minus the correction factor, where alpha 1, alpha 2, and alpha 3 can assume value 0, 1, 2. Each of these sum of squares will have 2 degrees of freedom.